This video is going to be about the rules for divisibility by 3, 6, 9, and 12. And I want to start with the rules for deciding whether you can divide a number by 9. So here's how the rule works. Take the number, let's say we've got a 72. I want to know if I can divide that by 9. Take the digits in the number and add them together. So I'm going to add together 7 plus 2. 7 plus 2 equals 9. If I end up with a 9, after that addition, it means that my original number, the 72, is also divisible by 9. Let's try a bigger number. Let's try 2,637. So I'm going to add the digits. I'm going to add 2 plus 6 plus 3 plus 7. Well, 2 plus 6 is 8, plus 3 is 11, plus 7 more is 18. I've ended up with a two-digit number, so I'm going to add those digits together, the 1 plus the 8. 1 plus 8 is 9, so my original number, 2,637, is divisible by 9. So let's talk about why this works, because it's kind of an interesting process. Let's start with some number that we know is divisible by 9. So let's start with, let's say, 18. 18 is 2 times 9. So I know it's divisible by 9. I also know that because if I add the 1 and the 8 together, I get a 9. Now, when I add a 9 to it, 18 plus 9 is 27. When I add a 9 to a number divisible by 9, the sum of those two numbers would also be divisible by 9. I can keep adding more and more 9s. In effect, it's like saying I've got 2 times 9, and I'm going to turn it into 3 times 9. And then I would turn it into 4 times 9 if I added another 9. So I'm going to keep ending up with numbers divisible by 9 as long as I'm constantly adding a 9. Now, let's take a look at what happens when I add 9. When I add a 9, I could think of myself as adding 10 and subtracting 1. I mean, after all, 9 equals 10 minus 1. So if I have 18 and I want to add 9 to it, I could add 10 and subtract 1. Now let's look at the digits involved in that process. I've got 18, which is 1 plus 8, and then I'm adding 10. My digits are 1 plus 0, and then I'm subtracting 1. So I've taken that original 1 plus 8, and basically I've added a 1, I've added a 0, and I've subtracted a 1. Well, adding a 1, adding a 0, and subtracting a 1 is the same as doing nothing. So if my original number had its digits add up to 9, then my next number, the next multiple of 9, is also going to have its digits add up to 9. And this will keep going and going and going. Okay, so that's the reason that this trick works, that you can add all the digits and see if the result you get is divisible by 9. Okay, let's talk about 3. To determine whether a number is divisible by 3, see if when you add its digits, you get either a 3, a 6, or a 9. So we could take the number 411. I want to know whether I can divide that by 3. So I'm going to add 4 plus 1 plus 1. 4 plus 1 plus 1 equals 6. I needed either a 3 or a 6 or a 9 to know whether I could divide by 3. So 411 is divisible by 3. Now, of course, if I add up my numbers and I end up with a 9, that also means it's divisible by 3 as well as divisible by 9. Okay, so to decide whether a number is divisible by 3, add up the digits. If you end up with a 3, a 6, or a 9, that number is divisible by 3. Let's look at the rule for 6, deciding whether a number is divisible by 6. Basically, what we're going to do is two tests. We're going to see if we can divide a number by 3. In other words, do its digits add up to a 3, a 6, or a 9? And we're also going to see if it's an even number. For a number to be divisible by 6, it would have to be even. So if I have a number like 1,242, let's see what happens. I'll add up the digits, 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 4 more is 7, plus 2 more is 9. So I know, by the way, that this number must be divisible by 9, but I just wanted to know if it was divisible by 3, which it is, because I've ended up with a 3, a 6, or a 9, and it's an even number. So that means I can divide 1,242 by 6. Okay, so in other words, the number has to be even, and I have to end up with a 2, I have to add up my digits to a 3, 6, or a 9. There's going to be a similar trick for deciding whether I can divide a number by 12. And basically the trick is going to work like this. Once again, add up the digits, see if you get a 3, a 6, or a 9, and then decide whether you can divide the number by 4. If you can, the number is going to be divisible by 12. So let's take the number 1,248. I'll add up the numbers, 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8. So 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 plus 8 is 15. I'll add the 1 plus the 5, and I get a 6. So since I got either a 3, a 6, or a 9, I know the number is divisible by 3. And then I'm going to look at the number and see if I can divide it by 4. Well, I can, because all I have to do is look at the last two digits, the 4 and the 8, and 48 is divisible by 4. So this number, 1,248, is divisible by 12. So once again, the rule for 12 is make sure the number is divisible by 3 and make sure it's divisible by 4. If it's divisible by both of them, then the number is also divisible by 12. Okay, so that's it for divisibility by 3, 6, 9, and 12. Take care. I'll see you next time.